Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Lawrence Cherney, Artistic Director of Soundstreams. Welcome to the opening of our 32nd season. The season continues on November 25th at Trinity St. Paul's Center with a program built around the Vespers. About 30 years ago, the wonderful Quebec composer Gilles Tremblay did a setting of the Vespers, and we're going to perform that on November 25th, along with exactly the same parts of the Vespers that were set by Monteverdi several hundred years ago with a period orchestra, and then the Tremblay with a contemporary chamber ensemble. So please join us on November 25th. You can still upgrade, you might say, your ticket for tonight into a season's subscription. There are some wonderfully nice people who will be at in the lobby at the table who would be very pleased to help you upgrade, and I can promise you we won't charge you $25 to check your bag. Seasons like this are only possible through the generosity of many companies, foundations, individuals, and government agencies. We'd like to thank TD Canada Trust, Bank of Montreal, the Toronto Arts Council, the Ontario Arts Council, the Canada Council, the Department of Canadian Heritage, and our media sponsors, Classical 96.3 and Now Magazine. I'd also like to give a very special thank you tonight to Michael and Sonia Koerner, who unfortunately couldn't be with us tonight, but the Koerners generously commissioned Paul Frehner to write the new work which is being done tonight. Now, some years ago, the Koerners also commissioned a much earlier piece of Paul Frehner's called Lila, which went on to win the Montreal Symphony's Vivier National Prize. So we hope that tonight's premiere will also have an auspicious future. I'd also like to mention that Daniel Hope's CDs will be on sale in the lobby, I guess at intermission and afterwards, and after the concert, Daniel will be in the lobby autographing copies of you if you'd like to take advantage of that. Long before Vivaldi, and ever since, composers have needed to express their feelings about their place and time, their own geography and culture. Everyone complains about the weather. I think it's a Canadian pastime to complain about the weather, but no one does anything about it. We're going to put a stop to that. In two short hours, we're going to run the gamut from frozen tundra to the sweltering heat of the desert and everything in between. You get to choose your favorite season. You may have to wait for it, but it will come round, I promise. Enjoy tonight's concert.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure, a great honor to be here in this fantastic hall. Max Richter, who couldn't be here tonight, but who sends his best regards, has asked me to say just a couple of words about the piece you're about to hear. Max contacted me about 2.5 years ago out of the blue with a rather unusual statement. He said, "I'd like to recompose the Four Seasons of Vivaldi for you." I didn't quite know what that meant, and so my response perhaps was a little flippant. I said, "What's wrong with the original?" And Max laughed, and he said, "Nothing's wrong with the original. In fact, how could there be anything wrong? It's perfect. Nothing's better than Vivaldi." So I said, "In that case, we're in agreement." He said, "The problem is not this wonderful music. The problem is the way that we've treated this music in the last 30 years. He said, "If I would just listen to it in concert halls or on CDs, that would be one thing. He said, but I hear it everywhere. I hear it in elevators. I hear it on hold. I hear it in parking garages." And he says, "I can't hear it anymore because my brain just blocks it out." And he said, "That's not fair to Vivaldi." And I thought that was interesting. The next interesting thing he said was, "In order to get away from this, to fall in love with the piece again, I decided to deconstruct it. And that's why I want to recompose it." Once he sent me the sketches, I realized he did love Vivaldi almost as much as I do. And he treated this masterpiece with great respect, and yet he'd reframed it in his own way. So you'll hear four seasons, as you would in the original, each have three movements. The setup is the same, except that he adds a harp for a different color. There are certain elements which are direct quotations from the Vivaldi. There are certain elements of ritornello from the Baroque times, which Max translates into a kind of a loop. He brings it into the 20th century. It's a wonderful piece. We've performed it around the world. We've recorded it. And tonight is the Canadian premiere. And I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.